Today we have been discussing about polar form of a complex number. Okay, so let us consider z is equals to x plus iy be a complex number. Be a complex number. Okay, now we can write on the polar form of this complex number. So now x plus iy is equals to r of cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay, x plus iy is equals to r of cos theta plus I sin theta is called a polar form of a complex number. This is the standard form of the polar form of a complex number, z is equals to x plus iy. First of all, have equating on both sides real part and imaginary parts. Equating real and imaginary parts on both sides of this equation number 1. Here the real part is r into cos theta. Here the LHS side real part is x, equating both of them. So then it is becomes x is equals to r cos theta. Okay. Next, right side imaginary part is r sin theta. Left side imaginary part is equals to y, equating them. Then we have to get y is equals to r sin theta. Is it clear? Next, squaring on both sides. You will get x square is equals to r square cos square theta. Next, here also squaring on both sides, you will get y square is equals to r square sin square theta. Let us consider this is equation number 2 and this is the equation number 3. Adding both of them. Okay. So adding equation number 2 and 3 is gives for LHS part x square plus y square is equals to r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. Okay. Next, x square plus y square is equals to, shall I take r square be the common? Yes. R square of cos square theta plus sin square theta. We know that cos square theta plus sin square theta value is equals to 1. So therefore, x square plus y square is equals to how much? R square. Okay. So therefore, finally, terminating small r is equals to under root of x square plus y square. Okay. This is the value of small r. What is the value of small r? Small r is equals to under root of x square plus y square. Okay. Next concept. So r sin theta, see here, r sin theta is divided by r cos theta. R cos theta is equals to r sin theta value is equals to y. Y by, okay, r cos theta value is equals to x, y by x, or r get cancelled. Sin theta by cos theta is equals to tan theta. So tan theta is equals to y by x. So the requirement is theta. So therefore, theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Okay, this theta is called argument z. Okay. So therefore, the argument z is equals to tan inverse of y by x. This is the second concept. Argument of z is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Okay, next, we have to check the four coordinates. Okay? According to first quadrant, okay, all of you observe this figure. Okay, so from this figure, okay, first quadrant, from this figure, shall I write tan theta is equals to opposite side by adjacent side. So that means y by x. Okay, no? So theta is equals to shifting this tan to opposite side, this becomes tan inverse of y by x. Theta is nothing but argument z. So therefore, argument of z is equals to tan inverse of y by x. That means in first coordinate we have to consider the argument z is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Okay, next go to second coordinate. So for second coordinate I am taking theta. Okay, it is the modulus of x and it is the y. Let us consider z equals to a complex number x plus I. Okay, so next from this second coordinate, tan theta is equals to, tan theta is equals to, so y by x. So theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Okay, so for second coordinate you have to consider the argument of z is equals to pi minus tan inverse of y by x. For second coordinate you have to consider the argument z value is equals to pi minus tan inverse of y by x. Next, let us consider the third coordinate. So it is equals to theta. Okay, it is the modulus of x, it is the y. Okay, from third coordinate again you are taking tan theta is equals to y by modulus of x. So theta is equals to tan inverse of y by modulus of x. For third coordinate you have to consider the argument of z is equals to minus pi plus tan inverse of y by x. You can understand straight. For third coordinate the argument of z is equals to minus pi plus tan inverse of y by x. Next, for fourth coordinate I am taking here theta. Okay, so it is opposite side. Okay, I am taking y. This is the theta. From this fourth coordinate, tan theta is equals to y by, okay, modulus of y by, and here I am making x. So theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Okay, for fourth coordinate we have to consider the argument of z is equals to, okay, minus tan inverse of y by x. Okay, argument of z is equals to minus tan inverse of y by x. Okay, I shall explain clearly once again. For first coordinate you have to consider the argument z is equals to tan inverse of y by x. For second coordinate you have to consider the argument of z is equals to pi minus tan inverse y by x. For third coordinate you have to consider the argument of z is equals to minus pi plus tan inverse of y by x. For fourth coordinate you have to consider the argument of z is equals to minus tan inverse y by x. Okay, for understanding purpose I am taking some examples. Write the polar form of the following complex number. First one is 1 plus I, second one is minus 1 plus I, third one is minus 1 minus I, fourth one is 1 minus I. Okay, so first one, all of you observe here. The first one is 1 plus I is equals to, what is the standard form of the polar form? R of cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay, already we have small r is equals to under root of 1 square is equals to 1, and plus again 1 square is equals to 1. Okay, small r is equals to root 2. Okay, or next 1 plus I is equals to, you have to multiply and divide with the root 2 here, then you have to get root 2 into 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 into I. For finding the theta, so already we have theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. It is equals to tan inverse of y value is equals to 1 and x value is also 1. 1 by 1 is nothing but 1. So 1. Next it is equals to tan inverse of, okay, so already we have tan 45 degrees is equal so much 1. So that's why I am taking tan pi by 4. Okay, tan inverse are reciprocal to each other. So that's why theta is equal so much pi by 4. So therefore the polar form of the 1 plus I is final answer. 1 plus I is equals to root 2 into cos pi by 4 plus I into sin pi by 4. Okay, so it is the polar form of the 1 plus I. Next, second, from taking second one, minus 1 plus I is equals to, first write on the standard form of it. So R of cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay, Next, small r is equals to under root of minus 1 whole square is equals to 1, and again 1 square is equals to 1. Finally, we are getting small r is equals to much root 2. So therefore, minus 1 plus I is equals to multiplying and dividing into root 2. Therefore, we get root 2 into minus 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 into 5. Next, find the augmented value. So theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Okay, so it is equals to tan inverse of y value is equals to 1 and x value is equals to minus 1. Submit here. You will get 1 by minus 1. 1 by minus 1 is equals to what? Minus 1. So therefore, tan inverse of, you will get here, minus tan 45 degrees. That means 5 by 4. Tan inverse are reciprocal to each other. So here I am getting theta is equals to minus 5 by 4. But this minus 5 by 4 does not satisfy the cos theta and sin theta. So here, the point P of minus 1 comma plus 1 is belongs to second quadrant. Okay, for second quadrant we have to consider the augment of z is equals to basic formula pi minus theta. Pi minus theta, that means pi minus pi by 4. Okay, pi minus pi by 4 is equals to, you will get 4 into pi, 4 pi, 4 pi minus pi is equals to 3 pi by 4. So that's why you have to consider the common angle is 3 pi by 4. Finally, here we get the getting the polar form of minus 1 plus I is equals to root 2 of cos of 3 pi by 4 plus I into sine 3 pi by 4. Okay, it is the polar form of minus 1 plus I. Next, the polar form of minus 1 minus I is equals to, first item the standard form, R of cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay, where small r is equals to root of minus 1 whole square is equals to 1, again minus 1 whole square is equals to 1. Here getting small r is equals to root 2. So therefore, minus 1 minus I is equals to, again multiply divided with root 2. You will get root 2 into minus 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 into I. Okay, next, already we have theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Y value is equals to minus 1, x value is also minus 1. Minus 1 by minus 1 is equals to much 1 only. So therefore, it is equals to tan inverse of theta is equals to tan inverse of y by x. Here y is equals to minus 1 and x is also minus 1. Minus 1 by minus 1 is equals to 1. Okay, so tan inverse of, for 1, tan pi by 4. Tan and tan inverse are reciprocal to each other. So therefore, theta is equals to pi by 4. But this theta is equals to pi by 4 does not satisfy the cos theta and sin theta. Here given complex number. Okay, the ordered form of this complex number is minus 1 comma minus 1 is belongs to third quadrant. Okay, for third quadrant we have to consider the augment of z is equals to minus pi plus theta. Theta is equals to pi by 4. Next, the LCM is equals to 4. 4 into minus pi is equals to minus 4 pi plus pi is equals to minus 3 pi by 4. Yes, you have to consider this angle. It is satisfied the both cos theta and sin theta. So that's why the polar form is minus 1 minus I is equals to root 2 into, so cos of minus 3 pi by 4 and plus I into sin of 4 minus 3 by 4. So this is the polar form of the minus 1 minus I. Next, the last one, fourth one, 1 minus I. 1 minus I is equals to, first item the standard form. The standard form is R of cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay, where small r is equals to root of 1 square 1 plus 1 is equals to how much? Root 2. Okay, so next, 1 minus I is equals to, again 1 plus dividing with root 2. You will get root 2 into 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 into I. Next, now theta is equals to tan inverse of tan inverse of y value is equals to minus 1, x is equals to 1. So therefore you get minus 1. So theta is equals to tan inverse of minus tan y by 4. Okay, here tan inverse cancel. So therefore theta is equals to minus y by 4. Okay, so here the given complex number order form is the point of 1 comma minus 1 is belongs to fourth quadrant. For fourth quadrant you have to consider the common angle is theta is equals to minus pi by 4 as it is. Okay, so therefore the polar form of 1 minus I is equals to root 2 into cos of minus pi by 4 plus I into sine of minus pi by 4. This is the polar form of 1 minus I.